Alright, so information technology systems, development of computer software. The three categories of IT professionals associated with the development of software. Alright, you have the programmer, you have the expert user, and you have the user. Right, the programmer is the one that will be the one who kind of develops the software. The expert user is the one that knows how to configure it and change it and all that good stuff. And then the user is the person that uses it and probably finds bugs and things for it. Outline two roles of any of the categories of IT professionals listed above. So let's go with programmer. They will come up with the solution and code it with the input of the user. And the expert user would learn how to modify and configure the software and do basic troubleshooting. And well, the normal user will just basically use day-to-day and report errors basically. Systems development life cycle is on the processes to develop software, and there's three stages of the associated with the one on the output or deliverable for each stage. Right, so the system development life cycle is like the different from the program development life cycle. The program development life cycle is basically just focusing on the actual coding part, but the system development life cycle will start from feasibility study, go straight on, right? So you would have a feasibility study. But the feasibility study, because they want the output or deliverable. So the feasibility study is going to give you, it should give clear insights about the chances of the project being successful. Right, then you will have the analysis phase. It would gather information about the problem, about the needs users or software, and obviously clear set of problem to solve. And then you have the design. It would create a framework or graphs that would give the system the structure it would have. Alright, so after design, feasibility study, analysis, design, then you would go into implementation. Alright, so it kind of models the problem development, the program development cycle, which is the PADIR, where it's propose would be kind of like feasibility, analyze, then design, then implement, and then review. The implementation will be coding and whatnot, and then review will be checking it out. So basically, one day I'm gonna do a one for all video and explain all of them separately, because I hate when I see these problems keep coming up and nobody cares about the student. Alright, discuss two benefits of using computer-aided software engineering tools. So case tools, one, they can automate tasks. They can automatically create diagrams of systems to aid in the development process, example EFDs or ERDs. Alright, and then they also aid in debugging software. They can do simple error catching that allows developers to find issues quickly. Example, software testing. Oh no, finding syntax and logic errors. Finding syntax and logic errors. Yeah, so case tools, they kind of like their job is to automate creating of diagrams, test doing simple tests, structuring the system, making things look better. Yeah, that's the job of a case tool, because it takes away some of the manual labor that you had to keep doing to get the software to work. Programming languages are used to write the instructions of computer software. List two examples of programming languages. All right, thanks. C++ and Java. Yeah, Python, JavaScript, stuff like that. Outline two reasons why a company may select a particular programming language to implement a given software package. All right, so usually different programming languages give you different advantages. So you want to say speed. Some languages are able to run faster on less powerful hardware, which would be better for the company. And the second one wouldn't be speed, it'd be portability. Portability, the code that is used on one machine can easily be reused on another machine. It can easily be reused on another machine. Example, JavaScript. Actually, we don't need an example for this. Call the mark, so we give the portability and we give the reasoning. So that should be okay then. Alright, number four. Computer networks are commonly used in many organizations. Discuss three functions of our computer network. Jeez, wow, is that a wicked question. Okay. Function one, connectivity. A network allows multiple machines to be able to connect to each other and share information via the use of protocol. Example, TCP-IP. That's plenty. All right, next. Function of a computer network, sharing resources. A network can allow for centralized storage of information that can be accessed by multiple computers on the network. Example, a client server network. And three would be security or access control. The network could allow only certain users to access certain resources based on their username and password. Example, access controllers. Yeah. Ooh, that's a hard 9 marks to work for it. Oh, 3 marks, 1 word is your point, explanation is your first sentence, and then your example is your 2 mark. It would fall under sharing resources. Like, your computer network on it by itself doesn't give you the ability to back up data. You can back up data without a computer network. So you gotta ask yourself, like, could this be done without a network? When you give the answer, you're like, can it be done without a network? That kind of vibes. Alright, protocols are important. An important component of a computer network, define it in protocol. Okay, a protocol is a set of instructions that... A protocol is a set standard of communication that allows multiple devices on a network to be able to exchange data with each other. Example, TCP/IP. I would define it as rough. That's rough. Alright, list three examples of protocols used for communication on the internet. HTTP, FTP, TCP/IP, voice over IP. Yeah. Those are good. A number of different technologies work together to facilitate the operation of the World Wide Web. Define the term uniform resource locator. Alright, 3 marks, boy. A URL is a string of characters that resolve to an IP address and define a location on the internet. Location of a resource on the internet. Yeah. Defining URL for 3 marks is hard, but especially since they give you like the uniform resource locator. Okay, give an example of a complete uniform resource locator. A complete URL? Wow. Alright, so we have started the protocol. https://pets.com/users/bob.html. Alright, so you have the protocol, you have the domain, then you have a folder, and then you have a page here. Wait, I didn't realize I answered it. Okay, I'll just take this exact same thing. I feel that's because I remember I answered this already. And I just feel right out here. We'll just put this right back right there. Yeah. Any three, protocol, domain, folder, or page. Yeah, those are the parts of a URL.